Hi guys, welcome back to the Mutual Friends podcast, and today I have a very fun mutual friend, Natalie Barbu.
Hello, I'm so excited to be here.
I'm so excited. The second time we podcast together?
Yeah, but the first time I honestly don't remember when it was, and I feel like we didn't know each other that well.
No, we didn't know each other that well. Now we're like friends, you know, all the things, so I think we'll have a lot more to talk about.
Yeah.
We were just talking about our shoes. So you said that these remind you of Miami Dolphins?
Yes.
Yeah. Here's the thing. I, of course, don't, like, I don't know anything. That's football, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway. I mean, I don't know much about football either, but I am from Miami, or I live in Miami, and, like, my family are huge Miami Dolphins fans, so that it stands out to me.
I got these for my birthday in June, and I've gotten so many comments about, like, oh, Miami Dolphins.
You just got to own it.
Yes. Well, here's the thing. I looked at these online, sent them to my husband. I was like, birthday, please. Saying, I think they look like Perry the Platypus.
Oh.
Like, in my head, it was full Perry the Platypus. Did not think Miami Dolphins. And then I got them. And now every, like, especially in airports, it was like, oh, Miami. And I'm just like, yeah.
I'm going to wait. I can't wait for the day when someone compliments you on them. And instead of saying, oh, Dolphins, they're like, oh my god, Perry the Platypus.
Perfect. I mean, like, my people, you get it.
That is so funny.
Yeah, these have been my favorite shoes.
I really like them. I should get some that color just because I live in Miami, so it would make sense.
It would make sense. I really like the green ones.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like everybody has the
green ones. I have the green ones, and then I have these.
Yeah, they're really, really good. I can't get out of my white sneaker era.
Me either. I want to go to this, like, a store here in New York while I'm here and get, like, the chunkier ones. You know, like,
yes.
I think they're $150, maybe? I don't know the numbers.
I'm not sure.
I need to look it up again. Yeah. But I want, like, chunkier white sneakers. And then I want, like, a very thin white sneaker, like the Vejas or...
Yes.
Is that I've how seen you pronounce that. Okay. It?
Thoughts on Sambas. Like, have you seen, like,
the Sambas? I do like them.
I love them.
I like them a lot. I think they will become like the other Adidas shoes that were really popular when we were in college. Do you remember the all white with the three black lines, like the classic Adidas shoe?
Oh my god, yes. Like, and they were like big, much bulkier, much rounder.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was like the first white sneaker trend, I feel like,
no,
that happened.
It was 100%. For our age.
So I do think that they will probably become like that, and we'll be like, why did we all wear those?
Yeah.
But I still like them, and I'll probably try to get them.
No, I want them so bad. And here's the good thing about the South. We are late with almost every trend.
Yeah.
Or they just never come. So when I'm in New York, I can kind of look around. And here I'm like, oh, everybody has Sambas. I'm just going to be another basic bitch. Whatever. Yeah. I go home.
You're
fashion,
one of a kind.
Vogue. Stunning.
Yes.
Correct.
Well, also, I do think Charleston is maybe a little bit more ahead.
Charleston's a little bit more ahead. A little bit more.
But
more up there. And
it's still preppy.
Yeah, it's very preppy.
So you're going to be like, who's that, like, street style queen over there?
Yeah.
Like,
very preppy. And I really like that this does not help. It was, I didn't bring like a proper, I only brought a sweatshirt, and it dropped, you know, below 80 degrees here. Yeah. So I was like, oh God, winter. And so I borrowed this blazer.
Uh-huh.
So this doesn't help my argument. I really don't like the preppy style. I think probably because I'm surrounded by it.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I could be, like, I think the uniform would be Sambas, like, a little high sock, this flowy skirt, because everybody's wearing the flowy skirts, and then they do, like, these mini tops. Like, everybody in Soho.
Yeah.
It's, like, the mini crop tops.
I love it. I love it. No
style.
I'm also immune to the cold. Like, I don't do cold well. And so here, like, yeah, it was, like, 66 degrees or something, and I went on a walk in the morning. I was like, oh my god, fall weather is here.
Fall weather. Everybody's like, this is so nice. I'm like, I'm freezing.
I know. I'm like, it's fall. I mean, it's so nice walking outside and not being hit with like a thick, you know, humidity. Like,
yeah, that is nice.
In Florida right now, it's like,
because my house
so
drips.
Humid. Yeah, no, I wake up and my windows are all fogged up.
Yeah,
like, that's like, if it's not fogged up, I'm like, oh, it's not humid outside. Yeah. That's so nice.
And yeah, and Miami's another world of
hot. Right now in the summer.
All year long, right?
It's hot all year long, but in the winter it's so nice because it's not that humid in the winter, and it's like 70s, 60s, 70s, so it's like perfect.
That's so nice. I told Joseph, I was like, we're not moving anywhere more north than Charleston.
Yeah.
I physically can't.
Why did you choose Charleston again?
I'm from there. Like, my family is 15 minutes away from my house.
Okay, I did not know that.
That was like not a plan, but like I didn't think I was going to come back to Charleston after college.
Yeah.
Because like I thought it was really lame to go back home. Mm-hmm. But then Joseph, you know, we were applying for jobs, and I originally had a job in Colombia, and then he was applying for jobs. He was like, oh my gosh, like I got a job with the Navy, and you know, at the Charleston Navy base. And I was like, are you for real? Like, that's like awesome. Of all the places in the United States, that is where, so, but it actually worked out. Cause I really like, I love being near family. I think there'll be a time, you know, it was a little weird. Like, I literally am in the same school district that I grew up in.
Yeah.
That, and I was like, eh. But I think that it works out. I don't think we'll be there forever, ever. But I will probably keep the house for, like, a rental property or something. Yeah. And I like that we'll have, like, something always. Because I have, like, aunts and uncles around me, the grandparents, my parents. My parents live 10 doors down from my grandparents. I live 15 minutes away from them. Across the street is my aunt and uncle. Down the road is my other aunt. Wow. Like,
all your family.
Oh, yeah.
What about his family? Where are they?
He has, like, a very small family. So, all that's really, unfortunately, that's left is his mom, who goes between Destin, Florida, and Alabama.
Okay.
Because they have a property in Alabama. And then his grandma in Alabama and his other grandma in Arkansas.
Okay.
And that's, like, it.
Oh, wow. So, they're a little bit more spread out. But yeah, a little bit more spread out.
Yeah, yeah. Not too far. Like, they're kind of, like, in this little corner. But then, yeah, we got married. And he came to a family reunion. I was like, buckle up. Like, this is, we're built on, I say we're built on happy divorces because, like, had many, like, splits and, like, merged families, and we just done really well. And, like, there's, you know, I think in other families, I guess I don't know how it is. Like, there's a lot of cousins I'm not blood related to. Uh-huh. I don't know anything different. That's what I grew up with.
Yeah, I mean, everyone, like, so I consider all of my, like, first, second, third cousins, whatever, like, anyone that's related to my mom or dad, but I don't really know how that we're related. Yeah. They're just my cousin.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Everybody's a cousin. My cousin. And I have a million.
Yeah.
A million.
Yeah. No, everyone. Like, I just call everyone my cousin. And if they're older, then they're like an aunt or uncle.
Yeah.
Like, that's if it's like above my generation, aunt, uncle.
Because when it gets like spread out like that, there's some people that I'm like, how are you my cousin and you're like 55?
Exactly. That's not real. You're my aunt.
Yeah, yeah, that's not, you're, yeah.
You're not my cousin anymore.
100%. I had to, like, draw him a little map, and he was like, wait. Who was married to who? I was like, no, they're not married anymore. Like, keep up. Yeah. All these people, he's like, how many people, like, kids do these people have? I'm like, just hold on.
Yeah.
Like, drawing the whole thing. I think he was a little overwhelmed, but I think it worked out. He's doing okay.
That's good, though. Yeah. I mean, I feel like Charleston's such a nice place, too. And, like, you're going to keep, like you said, the house around.
It. Yeah.
It's going to grow, like, in value so much. Because I feel like, okay, do you feel this being, since you are also an influencer. I don't know if you like that word.
But no, yeah. I don't think that we should put a negative connotation around it.
I don't think so, either. I'm like, you know what? Yeah, that's what I am.
Yeah. It is what it is. Yeah.
But since you are one and you are living in Charleston, do you feel like a lot more people are moving there? Because I've been seeing a lot more, like, influencers moving there.
Yes.
And I'm like, this is interesting. Yeah. Like, is Charleston, like, a hot spot for this now?
I think it's a huge, a lot of young people are moving there. And then, we are getting, like, this sort of small group of Charleston influencers. Like, I mean, you can literally, like, name them, like, Nicole, Two Blondes. Like, we have this little conglomerate of, and I really want to get in it. Like, I think they might all know each other, and I'm just this weirdo, like, kind of on the outside. Mm-hmm. Because it's also like Charleston influencers typically, like, fit, like, this very Charleston aesthetic.
Yeah.
Very Instagram forward.
Yes.
And I got started blogger on TikTok. Yes, type. Very blogger.
Yeah.
Beautiful. I think, like, you know, the OGs are, like, Vanita Aspen for us, and then Julia, and it's a really long last name. She's been around for
really, like, I know Ellie Thuman just moved there.
Ellie Thuman. When Ellie Thuman moved to Charleston, I was like, what are you doing here?
That's
like,
okay. That's, I think, why I was like, are influencers moving?
Yeah, and then she, like, brought her friends and, like, they'll come visit. And I'm like,
because she's very, like, LA, I feel like.
Yeah, like, it felt very random. I still don't know. I mean, we're not friends, so I don't know. But, like, why? Like, I think Charleston's amazing. But why?
Yeah.
Like, we're not close to anything. The closest, like, big city is Atlanta. And Atlanta doesn't really do, like, events. And now I'm just starting to get to the point where, like, I'm getting asked, you know, and people will send you, like, oh, you're invited to this event in LA. It's in 2 days.
I know. Okay.
Like, what?
I get that all the time. Or, like, in New York, in LA. I'm like, I appreciate the invite. Yeah. Keep sending them. Yeah. Maybe one day I'll be there. But, like, do you think I live there or do you think I'm just going to fly out for
this?
Yeah,
it's, I was like, huh? And we, like, there's nothing in, like that in Charleston. We're way too small for that.
Yeah.
But I also think that, like, I'm really, I thought about joining the Chamber of Commerce so that I could, like, be, hold on. Because I was like, oh, like, I can build relationships with, like, the Charleston local businesses and be able to, like, promote and, like, because I feel like nobody, there'll be, like, events that I see, there, it's literally, like, this, like, gang.
Yeah.
Like, this influencer gang of Charleston influencers. Yes. And I see that they're at, like, some event and I'm like, bitches, I want an invite.
Like, I know. Yeah.
I am one of you.
I know.
So I'm like, I need to get in them. Whatever room is being talked in, I would like to be there.
So, Chamber of Commerce. I think that's where the influencer events are actually being planned.
In my mind, I was like, oh, Chamber of Commerce, all the businesses know each other and all the business owners know each other. So then I'll be like in their little businessy meetings and be like, I'm the token influencer.
So I might be dumb, but what do you do at the Chamber of Commerce?
I don't know.
Okay.
No, I don't know. I don't know. I know that people like, they. I'm
like, is that something that like those businesses would then have to like go through you? You're like, if you want to plan an influencer event, you need to invite me.
I don't know. I really don't know. I just, in my head, the Chamber of Commerce is where all the business owners get together and they probably drink coffee and chit chat and then go home.
And like, you're
that's like, what I assume. And that was like, and I'm a big fan of social chit chat and I really think that's where moves are made.
Yeah. So I like, actually, I think you should do it and like vlog your experience.
Yeah.
Is, okay, this is also another dumb question. Do you get voted? Or is it like a, is it?
Like it, like in my head, Chamber of Commerce and Congress. I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm like, are you being like voted into it? Or is it something you sign up for?
I know,
and
like a,
people inside like a determine it?
Club.
Okay. I don't, I'm, this people is, in the, are going to be listening being like, you guys are so dumb.
And the thing is like, I can't, whenever I hear a podcast and it's like, are you dumber than a fifth grader? I can't listen because I get pissed. I get really, really mad.
When they can't. Oh my God.
It infuriates me. And so now I'm so sorry. I'm going to be the infuriating one. I know, but for all the girly pops who have no idea what the Chamber of Commerce is, sleuth on the loose. Like I will be there.
Okay, the Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader thing is so funny because I listened to one recently. I'm not going to, like, say the podcast, but I listened to one recently. Some of the questions were, like, it was concerning that they did not know the answers.
Yes.
And I was like,
no, and when they started deliberating back and forth.
Yes, and they're like, wait, no, it's this. Oh, yeah, I think you're right. And I'm like, girls, you're both wrong.
Girls, come on.
I'm like, please, like, this is so, like, I was like, you're brave for posting this. Like,
yeah. There was a podcast, I think there was a podcast I listened to, and they didn't post it, and then they released it as, like, a, I don't know, vault episode, because they were like, we're not going to post this.
It's so funny.
And, yeah.
Do you listen to Chicks in the Office?
No.
So, I honestly watch them more on, like, TikTok or Reels, like, when they come up, but I do listen to them sometimes. And there was one clip that they posted to like make fun of one of the hosts because it was like so dumb. And she like knows that. She was like, I just found out this crazy thing. She was like, so did you know that when you take the year you were born and add whatever age the person, or if you take the year someone was born and add whatever age that person is, it always equals 2023. No. Like the year that we're in.
No.
And like her co-host and like the producer, they're like, are you serious? They're like, we can't tell if this is like a bit or like if you're like serious or not. And she was like, yeah, like it worked. Like it's like I was born in 1996. I'm 27.
Oh, she's like trying to explain the math.
Yeah. Like I'm, you know, it's everyone's equals 2023. And it's like, that's how age works.
Do you listen to the Bad Broadcast?
No.
She has something called the Dumb Dumb Club. The Dumb Dumb Club I do appreciate because I think one of their universal like dumb things, and it's not like, are you smarter than a fifth grader? Like, and I have several. Like, I for sure, this is sort of the lane that I sit in. And this was mine. Of course you knew. Everybody knew this except for me. and I didn't like verbalize it until I was probably 24. And I always still get it mixed up, like pounds.
Huh.
Like when you abbreviate pounds, what are those letters?
LBS.
Yes. I, for my whole life, have said like, oh, 10 ibs. I said it to Joseph. I was like, oh, we need like 3 ibs of that. He was like, 3 what? I was like, ibs? He was like, look me in my eyes. What did you just say? I'm like, 3 ibs. He was like, you have, you know, when other people discover it and they're like, please tell me your whole,
yeah,
this isn't, is this the day that you learn? Like, yes. And I'm like, what?
So I had something like that recently, and it was actually the last time I came to New York. I came to New York with my friend. It was Catherine and Chanel, and Catherine's like, oh my God, Natalie, like, you'll never believe what Chanel just said. Like, this is so funny. And it was like, she was like looking at like cute dogs.
Mm-hmm.
How do you pronounce like the traditional name of like a wiener dog? Like, do you know?
Dachshund.
Okay, so me and you are on the same page then.
Dachshund. If I read it, it's not. You don't pronounce it. You don't say it. You think about the word. You say, nope, not going to do it. And then you go wiener dog. That's how that goes.
So I never knew that it was pronounced like dachshund.
Is it doc or dot?
Dot. Okay, now I'm.
Huh?
Dachshund.
Like with a C? Dachshund?
Dachshund.
Is it with a D at the end? Or dachshund?
Yes.
Okay.
And I always thought, I knew that that was the name of a wiener dog, like when I see that. But when I thought that that was different than dachshund. I thought dachshund was how you pronounce it, because that's how it's spelled, but it's like a German word. So then you pronounce it dachshund. And she was like, oh my God, Chanel just thought that this dog was pronounced dachshund. And
like, I was like, Chanel, you're so dumb.
I was like,
sitting there like,
yeah, it is.
It is.
And she was like, do I have two friends that don't know that this is not pronounced this way?
I want, like, this needs to be a whole episode. Like, I need submissions, because, like, the smarter than fifth grader can't do. Like, that makes me want to die. This, hysterical.
Yes. I've seen a TikTok. It's like one of those, like, stitch this with a word that you've been pronouncing wrong your whole life.
Yep.
I died laughing, or like laughing through the comment section of those videos.
Oh,
like the if words you send people.
It,
can
you,
yes.
I need you to send it.
I'm going to find it and I'm going to send it to you, because it is so funny. The things that like people mispronounce.
Yeah.
And it's like, we all have words that we mispronounce and that's like so far off, and just no one's corrected us for like our entire lives. Like for me, that's still a dachshund. That's still like that is how I pronounce
and you know
that
what?
Dog.
You know what? We had Maddie Murphy on last week. That should be celebrated. That's what she said. That should be celebrated. Yeah, we should. There's some things that I think we should just like, we're like, nope, flags here. We're not moving.
Mm-hmm.
We will not move.
Like, it's too hard. It's in my brain. That's how I associate. I look at that word and I say that. I look at the dog and I say that.
Yeah.
Like, and then, but you're right. I should just start calling it a wiener dog and that's it.
No, honestly, everything to me is part of a brand. Mm-hmm. So it's now part of your brand to say dachshund.
Okay.
It's like, and then that makes it cool. And it's uncool if you don't say dachshund. It's like, oh, like.
Yeah.
You're not really in on it.
Exactly.
I'm sitting with a friend. This is so random. And then we'll get into the group chat. But I was with a couple friends, and one of our friends is getting married, and she's quite religious. And so we were asking like them, like, oh, like, we hadn't met the guy, like, oh, is he religious as well? And me and this girl are religious. And she said, oh yeah, he's in on it.
He's in on it.
I was like, he's in on it. He's like, what?
So, in on what?
In on what? It sounds like we told him a secret. And he's like, oh, yeah, I know. I got it. You go to church. It's okay. That's so funny. Oh, okay. Are you ready for the group chat? This is where we talk about trending news, trending topics.
Yeah.
If you have anything you'd like to add to the group chat, you're also welcome.
Okay.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yes.
It's like a fun, I made a fun little sound.
Oh, cool.
Insert here.
Okay.
Okay. All right, this one had me, like, those existential crises. This put me into one of those. The Good Luck, did you ever watch Good Luck, Charlie?
Yes. Yes, I did.
Yeah. It was Pop Crave tweeted, that girl's in ninth grade.
The little Charlie. Girl? I know.
That is so bad.
Yeah.
That and is like, so bad.
It's crazy because her generation didn't watch Good Luck Charlie because she's so little.
Yeah.
So, like, no one in her grade probably even cares that she was like one of the, like,
you're just
one of a huge Disney Channel
Mia.
Shows.
Her name is Mia Tellerico.
Wasn't that her name in the... Oh, no. Obviously, it was Charlie.
Yes. Yes.
I'm like, wasn't that her name in the show? No, her name was Charlie.
Yeah, wasn't somebody's name Mia?
I feel like it was, like, the sister or something. Like, Bridget Mendler's character? She was on the show, right?
Yeah. That was her.
Maybe not. Maybe I just knew her name was Mia when, because the credits would always say
no,
Mia.
No, and I don't. You know what? I like totally. I'm with you because I saw Mia and that sounded familiar. Like there was some sort of relation to the
maybe just like name the credits Mia. We've
maybe yeah we took it in. Yeah, I don't. Are there any shows like this for, like, what are middle schoolers watching these
TikTok
days?
And like YouTube Shorts and Reels? I think. Yeah. I don't think Reels. I think it's YouTube Shorts and TikTok.
Are they still Are there still like YouTube kids? Like,
yeah, I think so. I went to visit. It's actually like so sad at how addicted so many kids are to their phones.
Yeah.
But I went to visit my cousin's kids. So I also consider them my cousins.
Yeah, that's how that family. I don't know.
Yep. And everybody's so cousin. They are like little. They're like the oldest one is 9 years old.
Yeah.
And they're constantly watching YouTube and YouTube Shorts. Like they don't have TV shows that they watch. They just watch their iPad. And they scroll on their parents' phones.
What's happening to Disney Channel?
I don't know. Because I don't think that there are shows like Hannah Montana, Wizards of Waverly Place, like Sweet Life of Zack and Cody. Like, those shows don't... The shows like that don't exist anymore, I feel like, because kids are now watching YouTube.
Yeah.
Or, like, maybe there's, like, streaming shows for kids, like Netflix Kids or something. Or, but I don't think, like, traditional TV has, like, shows for kids that are that popular anymore. That have the impact that those shows did for us.
Yeah.
Or like DCOMs. Do you know what a DCOM is? The Disney Channel original movie.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, like, yeah, yeah, of course. Of course, those, of course, like, of course.
Don't exist anymore, I think.
That's so sad. Mm-hmm. Do you remember when Netflix came out with their first movies? And they were like asshole casserole. Like they were bad.
Wait, I only remember when Netflix came out with Orange is the New Black. That was like the first streaming show.
Yeah.
And it was like controversial for some reason.
Prison Break.
Was that a Netflix original?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. But I think.
Maybe.
Okay. But I think Orange is the New Black was like the first like Netflix production show.
Yeah.
And it did like so well.
That did. Yeah. I didn't watch it. I remember, I think I was in college. And I remember, like, watching the first 5 minutes of the first episode. And I was like, I, like, ran. I did the same thing with Game of Thrones. And, like, now as a more adult person, I, like, I can, you know, I'm not a weenie. And
yeah, you're.
it's House of Cards.
House of Cards. That was the first one. Okay.
House of Cards was the first Netflix, like, original.
Yeah, February.
2013. House of Cards is from 2013.
Yeah, I guess I was. When did you graduate high school?
Hold on.
You graduated in 2012. When did you graduate high school?
2015.
Okay, I'm 2014. Yeah. So yeah, it was around. I guess you were just out of high school, and then I was like,
House of Cards was so good.
I never watched it. I felt like I was missing out.
It's so good, but you get to like, if you like. Get really addicted, and then you watch it a lot, and then you realize that you don't feel very good.
Mm.
You're like, oh, I have like kind of a gross feeling.
Yeah.
And then you realize it's because you're watching House of Cards. Same thing happened to me with Shameless.
Yeah.
Shameless, I watched, I was like, I feel not good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I feel that way with like Euphoria.
I was told not to watch Euphoria.
I like it, but I feel that way because it's very like, there's just a lot of like heavier topics in it. So I feel like that's why I feel that way. But maybe also House of Cards could be because you were watching Kevin Spacey, you know, like what happened to him.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. could. Okay. I knew that.
Okay.
Was
so it's House of Cards, then Orange and the New Black.
Okay.
Really?
Wow.
Oh my God. 2013. That's crazy.
But that's crazy. If you think about 10 years ago was the first Netflix show and now like they're literally creating like the most popular shows. Like it's so crazy at how much happens in just like 10 years.
Rip Redbox.
Yeah.
Redbox got fucked over.
There's still Redboxes around though. And I'm like,
they're still at my local CVS.
Yes.
Who's getting them?
Who gets these? Like,
Southern States. Yeah. South Carolina, my North local
Carolina,
CVS.
In North Carolina, they have them too. But
do you still have property in North Carolina?
No, my family still lives there.
Oh, gotcha.
I bought a house there, flipped it, sold it. Yeah.
I don't, that's like terrifying.
It's, well, okay, so my family does, like my dad builds houses. So like I have unfair advantage when it did come to that with like knowing what to do. So people are always like, how did you like plan everything and like know how to find the contractor? I'm like, my dad was my general contractor, so it was like a lot easier for me.
But use your resources.
Yeah. Oh, I'm resources. Not apologizing. Yeah.
No, absolutely not. Okay. Are you in on the Bobby and Drake stuff?
Kind of. So I didn't watch the interview because I think I felt like I watched it with all the TikTok clips that were out. So I was like, I don't think I need to watch the whole thing. I just watched the highlights on TikTok. Yeah. I thought it was really funny.
I thought it was funny. I think what like her bit, I think like the what she's doing is smart. It's funny. Like I think that's part of like the backlash that she gets is because of her character. And I'm like, that's so dumb. Like she doesn't talk like that in real life. Like, yeah. This is part of the entertainment. Like it's entertainment.
Yes. So I thought it was really funny. I like what she's doing. I think it's crazy that she kind of came out of nowhere and like started
Did you watch the podcast that she BFF's pod when she was on it?
Only like TikTok clips again. Okay. So I saw like the highlights, you know, so and you I saw she like DM'd him.
Yes. Yeah. So it was like she just DM'd him and it was kind of like flipping, just kind of like shoot your shot and she got it. I think that's great. Like totally. And then did you see that she's like when she talked about the debt that she's put herself in producing this podcast? I was so thankful for her saying that because I was like, nobody talks about that. Mm-hmm. And also like, girl, like
she does not need to be doing that.
No, like I'm like, that doesn't, I mean, she was me in that. She's like, who else is going to pay for the plane ticket? And I was like, Bobby, I do not know. I do not know, but I don't think it's you. That's for sure.
Well, also I just think like, I feel like someone, if she has a manager, which I believe she does at this point, at least.
Yeah, I think so. Like, she just got signed with, like, one of the biggest PR teams ever.
Like, someone should be like, okay, you're getting Drake on the show. Before we release this, let's get some sponsors for the podcast.
Yeah.
Insert some sponsors for it because this is going to do really,
really well.
Especially once she started posting those clips on the on social media before the episode came out.
Right.
Someone should have been like, let me sponsor this.
Yeah, because I'm like, really? Is it, you're only relying on like the TikTok creator fund?
Like, I know. And isn't that like nothing? I feel like I don't even know if I'm in the TikTok creator fund.
The creativity beta program, that pays bills.
Wait, really? What is that?
It's they're like, so they have the original creator fund, then they launch creativity beta program, which you can opt into. Launched it I don't know when, but probably 6 months ago, it was more like everybody's talking about it, like if they're going to switch over, because once you switch over you can't switch back. It is bill paying.
Really?
Yeah, it is good. That and then like I have really gotten into TikTok shop. I don't think that TikTok shop is for every creator.
It's because you earn commission on it, right?
Yeah, between those two, like I make sure every TikTok shop video is over a minute, so I'm getting the commission and the like creator fund.
Wait, creator fund is only if it's over a minute?
Mm-hmm. Create the beta program.
Oh, mm-hmm. Can anyone join that, or what's the criteria? Do you know?
I think that I think it's just like over 10,000.
Okay.
I think something like that. Like it's not
hard.
No. Okay. No. It should just be like if you go like into your settings and it'll be like creativity beta program and then you can like opt in or whatever.
Okay,
and
I'm gonna try that.
I mean
your videos blow up.
When I'm in New York it's so hard because it doesn't know what to do with me, so all my videos are like less than 5,000. But I'm like, okay, just let the other ones roll and we'll get back to South Carolina and like
So funny because most people are the opposite. Like New York content does so well.
When I'm in New York, like my videos, it doesn't know where to put me.
So I think it's because because it's kind of confused because you're traveling and like that's not normally your location. But I also think that do you remember like 2016 to like 2019? I feel like when LA was the most popular spot for every influencer.
Yep.
Every influencer moved to LA. It was like everyone was kind of like sick of influencers moving to LA. It's like, no, don't tell me you're moving to LA. You're just gonna be like everyone else. New York has now become that, unfortunately, for the social media
very world. Much so.
Like it's, I feel like everyone lives here now. In the influencer space. And people are now, I think, getting tired of seeing creators post about New York stuff.
You know who else is blowing up that I think is, like, becoming, like, the new LA? Mainly because everybody from LA moved there.
Who?
Austin, Texas.
Oh, yeah. Austin also.
Everybody, because everybody realized, like, California is so expensive.
Yeah.
And, like, it's like, oh, like, New York is like, oh, it's expensive here. But no, like, and LA became like, no, we can't afford, we can't afford to live here. And, like, people who make millions, like, it's literally atrocious.
I'm waiting for Miami to become that.
Miami, like, Miami's heating up. Miami's like, it will not just, take
like,
long.
Alex Earle has really, like, put Miami in, like, influencers' thoughts, I guess. But I feel like Miami has a rap of, like, only being a party club place.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's like,
she's kind of reinforcing that.
Totally.
And
you
I,
know?
I, that's not a dog on her. I literally love her.
Yeah. No, but it's, like, that it just has that stereotype. Yeah. And so I think a lot of people think, like, if you move to Miami, you have to be in that world.
True.
And, I mean, I don't feel that way because I'm not in it and I live there. Yeah. But, like, I think that that's a huge part of it.
I think it'd be interesting to, like, I don't know how this would work, like, do a trip or, like, do it at VidCon or something and, like, get, okay, we're going to put the LA influencers over here, the New York influencers over here, the Miami influencers over here, and the Austin influencers over here. And then, like, we'll have, like, some rogue Nashville ones, like, right over there. And
oh,
just, like,
Nashville's another huge Nashville's one. Another I feel like Nashville one. And Austin can kind of get lumped into
they
one.
They can, yeah. The They're styles the same are very type. Similar. Same, yeah, same type. And then Utah and Arizona.
Yep.
All the Utah and Arizona people. All same type.
That's so funny. What? Like, where's the influencer in, like, I don't know, like, Montana or something?
Yeah, I was going to say Montana. Like, these Montana people don't. Like, who's in Nebraska?
Yeah.
Do people live there? Nebraska's one of the states I'm convinced isn't real.
I mean, I've never seen anyone really go there. I've never
seen
anybody
from there. I've never seen it.
It's like a social experiment.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, that's how I feel about the Dakotas. I've actually never met anyone from North or South Dakota.
No, that's not a, once again, social experiment, not real.
I know,
not real. It's not real. Wait, okay. So the Bobby and Drake thing. The latest? Oh wait, the BFFs pod. And did you see, like, Dave Portnoy, like, he did an apology or whatever?
Yes, yeah. And so, like, he was like, I heard that you slept with Drake and you're getting a divorce, and then. Then I heard something that was like, that Drake wanted, like, copyright.
Okay, here's the thing.
I was like, is that real or is that a rumor?
Okay, so what happened, like, she went to Drake's concert, and the same night that she went to his concert, all of the stuff was taken down from YouTube, TikTok, everything was taken down. Everybody's like, what the fuck? And then she had been on the BFF's pod, so Dave messaged her and was like, yo, I hear rumors about, like, you getting divorced and that you slept with him, I call bullshit. And her statement was, I'm not making a comment publicly about this, but no, that is not true. Mm-hmm. And he said, yeah, okay, cool. Then he said that on the podcast and he talked about the text, but then his team, the edit that they put out, her statement just said, I'm not making a comment publicly about this. They didn't put in that she said it's not true. And so it made her look really shitty. So there's, like, two parts. So she messaged Dave and was like, what the fuck? And he was like, that was totally, like, that was our bad. My team shouldn't have done that. He was like, I ripped into my team. They put out, like, public things. They did a TikTok that did the two edits next to each other to show, like, what happened, whatever. I was like, good on Dave. Like,
yeah.
So there's that. But with that drama, we were still like, okay, well, why did they get taken down?
Yeah.
So he played Rack City on.
Yes.
Yes. On the podcast. And it is interesting because on it, he was like, okay, let it get to this verse, like, you know, whatever. And so he had it play a certain amount of time. And supposedly he, like, they, you know, released the podcast or whatever. He's the one who played it and had it go on for a certain amount of time, like, to carry, like, to be part of the podcast. And then he is apparently the one that messaged the, like, music company or whatever and notified them about the copyright issue for Tyga.
So if then, that's true, that is so shitty on
so
him.
So fucking shitty. And so then she, like, you know, with the law enforcement or whatever, she would then, and this really sucks, coming after she came off the BFF's pod, she then has to give all that money to Tyga.
I would be.
And everybody's like, oh, Drake is being so shady. I'm like, Drake's being a motherfucking dickhead. Like, that's not shady behavior. That's shithead behavior. That's just poor, like, human cruel behavior.
Because you're so rich.
Yeah.
And this Which girl is, why I'm is
like,
not. This is,
I'm almost like, there's no fucking way.
That's
there's
why no I know. Way. I'm like, is that really is true? That, like,
yeah.
And like, also, I've been copyrighted before on YouTube, and I've never had to give the money.
Yeah,
you so just stop monetizing from that point on.
Right. So some people say that's like why it was all taken down is like that, I guess, instead of like paying the money, she took everything down. I don't know. You know, of course, I don't know the logistics. I don't even know how, is it public record who does a like a copy, like reports a copyright?
Yeah. So
citation?
When I get I copyrighted know. On YouTube, it does tell me who made the copyright claim, like the music label of who owns it.
Okay.
So like,
yes.
The label, whoever owns that song.
Yeah.
It is yeah. the one that has to make the claim. Like, so, I can't go in and be like, that's copyright, and then copyright right. someone else if I don't own it. So it does have to come from the label.
Yeah. So who, like, told – how it do we know that Drake be, told the label?
So
– and also, why would Drake do that?
On YouTube, though, I – like, they have their, you know, scan. They, like, scan the video to yeah. make sure that they don't hear anything. So it's not always – if someone doesn't always have to report it, it could be that the video picked it up and yeah. was like, that's that song. This yeah. is copyright. YouTube has gotten so strict with it. Like, there are times when people will literally be in a restaurant and they'll be filming and there's, like, background music and yeah. they will get copyrighted because it picks up that song. Yeah. So I'm wondering if he actually did that or if it's, like, it just happened to get scanned and then people now are saying that it was, the, like, who yeah. knows? Because I would be shocked if that, like, to me, I'm like, how, that would just, that's such bad publicity for him. It's so bad. And, like, yeah, and I don't think he needs that money, so...
So why? Like,
I would be shocked if that was
why. And it, like, it doesn't make any sense why. And then, like, to take everything down. So say that there was a copyright thing. Take everything down. She makes, like, a statement. And that's it.
Yeah.
But they unfollowed each other. Like, that's why what like, is going on?
Maybe they're gonna, like, do something where, like, he's gonna release a music video and she's gonna be in it. And it's, like, all this hype for that. You know, who knows?
If this is, like, all a stunt, I'd just be like, okay. We're getting too much.
It could
this
be
is
a stunt.
Getting way too much
because we're talking about it.
Yeah,
it's working.
True. It's work. No, it's working. I'm like, this is too much. Also, I'm part of the problem.
Yeah.
Speaking of stunts, have you heard about like the It's Just Ashley, girl, the Taylor Swift person?
Oh my god. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm a big Swiftie.
Are you?
Huge.
Okay.
So yeah. I love Taylor Swift.
I don't want to self. Label. Mm-hmm. I would say I'm an inductee. I'd say I'm in the academy.
Okay.
I'm learning. Okay. I've got a lot of Swifties around me who have been so kind to educate me on the Swiftie culture. Uh-huh. I understand Carly Kloss and yeah, what's going on with
deal.
That. Like I am going through album by album.
Okay.
And picking my favorite eras. I'm understanding lingo. Mm-hmm. So I'd like to like I'm coming.
Okay. Okay. Are we
getting there?
I'm definitely huge Swiftie.
Yeah.
And so with this girl on TikTok that's like pretending to be her, and then she's like, how could people think that I'm her? I have brown eyes. Taylor Swift has blue eyes. I'm like, you're wearing sunglasses. You're trying to look like her on yeah. purpose. You hired security to walk around pretending that you're a celebrity. What do you like? Are you dumb? Like, why are do you think anyone's going to believe you? Or is yeah. this just like, another thing to get a lot of views?
Right.
And also, like, I feel like you need to get checked out because impersonating yourself as anyone, if you are not, like, an actual impersonator for, like, a party.
Yeah.
You're weird.
Yeah.
Like, that's, like, it really
is,
weird.
It is very interesting. I didn't know who she was. And then – and she, like, partnered with – she – I think part of it is that she, you know, with her, she partnered with, like, a YouTube – person that I guess like does these stunts, and so that, you know, she was like, this, you know, was mainly just like he was like, you look like Taylor Swift, like we can, and she's like, yeah, and I'm like, okay. And YouTube stunt culture and
hate
like
it.
Pulling things, I'm not, I think we just get too far. I'm all for like do it for the content. I'm all for do it for the gram. Like I think it's great. I think like what Bobby's doing, I'm like funny, great, entertaining.
Yeah.
When you're involving like the public and like tricking people, that's when I'm like, oh man, like this line gets really thin, dude.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And
don't
like
know.
It's just weird. Like I think it's like imagine
and that's risky business to impersonate somebody that big with that big of a following and to that scale. It's one thing of just to acknowledge that you look well,
yeah.
like somebody, like I will, you know, say that Mark Wahlberg's my dad and I will immediately say just kidding. Like, there's difference. And then going out and, I mean, full, like, looking like, I'm like.
No, it's so weird.
Legally risky.
Yeah, I think it's risky. And I think it's just, like, strange. Like, I just always think about people that post, like, okay, for example, people that are doing, like, really just, like, prank videos and, like, weird things like that that, okay, fine, you get a lot of views.
Yeah.
Sure. But, like, do you not care about what people in your real life think about you? And I'm not saying to care what they think in the terms of, like, because people are going to care what, you know, like, but people will judge. If you're doing things
that are, like,
anyone. Like,
you're a shitty person behavior.
Yeah, like, I'm like, I would never.
Like, oh, well, we're doing it for YouTube. I'm like, that doesn't justify.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm like, don't people in your life tell you, like, this isn't right? I don't know. I just think it's very strange.
Very strange. No, like, somebody, like, tweeted, like, no, I can't get over the fact that Ashley Leachin, I don't know how to say her last name, Leachin, is married and has two children. Like, if my mom spent her free time walking around town pretending to be Taylor Swift, I would simply change my name and move to a different continent.
I didn't know that she had so kids. Harsh. Or, like, a husband. Like, her husband, like, does he not say, like,
like, maybe
a little weird.
Yeah, maybe we don't. Maybe we don't do that. Yeah. I think that people just get so caught up in, like, the thrill of the stunt and like, oh, how funny will this be? And don't think of, like, this. Yes, okay. This is funny for, like, thinking about in theory, talking about with your friends, like, closed room doing it.
It's like, you know who Nessa Barrett is? She's like a TikToker.
Yeah.
She has a girl that, like, literally does everything she does, got the same tattoos as her, got, like, changes her hair the same way as her. Every single photo is, like, the same exact pose as her.
Restraining order.
I'm like, it gets to a point where this is like, are you a stalker? And, like, or what? Like, I'm saying, you gotta be, like, a little, you know.
Yeah. A little.
Like, it's creepy. If someone did that to me, I would be like.
Okay, when you put it that way, because, and she's, you know, Nessa's big or whatever, but she's, like, not that Taylor Swift isn't a person, but the celebrity influence, whatever, I feel like I can relate a little bit more. That would scare me.
It would really scare me. Yeah. Like, same everything. Anything she posts, it's, like, the same exact stuff.
Straight restraining order. Yeah. The internet has, it's, like, it's interesting the problems that we're having to discuss. Like, like. I never thought that this would be, like, an issue that we would have to consider.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, it's been, like, a year and a half since, like, my laundry video went up. And, like, the conversations that me and Joseph have to have are very different.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you know, can't do this. We had our house painted. And, like, this guy, you know, he's like, can I post pictures? I'm like, here are the rules around posting pictures because people can't know, like, that this is my house. And, like.
Yeah.
It was like a whole thing.
Have you ever had anything creepy happen?
Thankfully, no. Nobody ever. I learned what doxing is. Never had anything like that. One of my friends, she's got like 2 million on TikTok and she's had a lot. And thankfully she's like in the military. So like they've had to move and those moves have coincided where they're like, okay, yeah, we just kind of got up and go. And it was like where he was getting moved or whatever. But no, I haven't had any weird things or
that's good.
That I know of. Like, I don't know if somebody's in front of my house taking pictures and I just am asleep.
I've had, the only weird thing that I've had is, well, one, this wasn't like weird. Cause I don't think it was like, I don't think it was someone creepy. I just think it was really inappropriate was when I did buy my house in North Carolina, someone commented on my post the address. They're like, oh, this is the address and she bought it for this much money because they like looked it up on like Zillow or whatever, and I just like deleted it and then blocked the words of like the street name and stuff like that.
Yeah, no, I didn't have like my like street name or anything. Somebody commented like, hey, you went to whatever high school, which it's not hard to find.
Yeah,
but I'm like,
but then no, you know the district that you know, you're in.
I'm like, no.
So, yeah, I was, like, so upset. And then I DM'd her, and I was like, why would you do that? Like, I was, like, really upset.
Oh, my gosh,
I
you
was
actually, like, converted her. Yeah,
because I'm like, why would you post my address on social media?
It's
like,
human decency.
Yeah, like, I wouldn't even do that for, like, just a normal friend. Like, that's just weird. And then the other thing that happened that was actually creepy was I got a letter from a prison. And I opened it, and it was, which one, they knew my address. You know, it was my parents' house, but they knew my parent, like, my address. And it was a prisoner who wrote me a letter for my birthday. And it was like, "Hi, Natalie. I just love your smile so much. All of this stuff about how happy he is when I smile and all of this. And I hope I have a wonderful birthday." And then something about, like, aligning chakras. I was like, okay.
Not me being like, "Oh my God, that's so nice. Like, how are you?" I would be like, "Oh, you know, the Andrews thing is, like, really creepy, but, like, you seem like such a nice person."
Yes. No, I felt bad. I mean, because I was just like, I don't know.
I think this is coming from, you would hope this is coming from a good place, but yes. Also, but it did come from a prison. So. Yeah.
And I'm like, how did you, do they watch YouTube in prison? Like, how did he know who I was?
Aren't they, like, prison influencers?
I mean, there's, like, prison TikToks or something, but I'm like, are they allowed? I don't know. Like, are they?
I think there's a lot around
that. So, like, that was really strange to me. And then I looked up, because whenever you get a letter from a prison, I learned, you get, like, the case, like, the person's number, I guess. Like, prisoners have, like, a certain number that they go by.
They did?
And so I looked it up. I looked up the prison, and then I looked up, like, what they did. It was, like, armed robbery.
Okay.
It wasn't murder. It wasn't stalking. It wasn't kidnapping. Yeah. I was like, armed robbery. I mean, could be worse.
It could be worse.
Could be worse. It could be worse.
So when we're looking at the, like, situation from, you know, positivity all around, like, let's take a look. We're like,
so okay. Very creepy. Like, yeah. I still was, like, concerned, but also he's not set to be released for, like, a few years too, so I was like, okay, he's not, like, being released this year, you know. And
were,
like,
your parents like, what?
Yeah, they were very like, ooh, like, that's very creepy, you know. Yeah. But my parents moved, like, right after that, not because of that. They were just, like, moving, so I was like, okay, whatever, like, we're moving anyways.
Yeah, that
but
works out.
I was just like, how did he, one, watch my videos, two, find, I mean, I guess it's easy to find people's addresses now, like, you just,
yeah,
it's really easy to find someone's address.
Oh, I figured that out.
Yeah. So, like, but I don't know. I was like, oh, is this guy, like, constantly watching my videos? Like, I don't know. Yeah, it's like, just, like, a little
supporter.
A little off-putting. When I, you know, I was like, okay, I mean, I'm just not going to, like, reply. Yeah. I'm not going to write him back. But, yeah, that was a little weird.
Oh, my God. But such a good story, though. Yeah. Never, like, are you in, like, I really have, I don't know if this will ever go away now where there's things that will happen and, I don't, like, people, like, have this phrase, like, do it for the plot.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, no. When you document your life,
mm-hmm.
when you have a podcast, when you YouTube, but everything truly does become, like, do it for the content. Yep. Or, like, that's content. Yeah. Everything can be this. It's like a text write-off, content.
Yep. I went on my very first, like, Hinge dates this past week. I went on 2 Hinge dates this week.
Oh my gosh, this is good because we're going to be talking about, like, dating relationship stuff. So let's.
Amazing.
Yes, I want to hear it.
So I went on 2 Hinge dates this week with 2 different guys. And it was my first time ever going on, like, a dating app date.
Okay.
And so I was, like, so nervous, but I was like, you know what? I'm just going to document it.
Yeah.
And I feel bad because I never want to, like, shit talk anyone, you know, even if I don't say their name, like, they're gonna know who it is if they see it. Yeah. So, like, I never want to, like, say anything bad until maybe, like, a year later when it's like, no one's gonna know who I'm talking about. So I'm careful about doing that. And then I also don't want guys to, like, see me on social media and be like, oh, she's gonna talk about me.
Yeah.
You know, so I only documented, like, the getting ready portion
it's
of,
like,
it.
It's like Taylor Swift, but, like, a little different.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I am pretty much Taylor Swift. So I, like, documented the getting ready and, like, my thoughts. Yeah. And then, like, people were like, update us. I think you commented on that too, I think. So then I did an update and it was like, the dude was super nice. So like, I was like, okay, I'll do an update on this because I'm not going to say anything bad.
Yeah.
But, like, if I did go on a really bad date, I would definitely document it. But then I would, like, post it, like, 6 months later or something where the person wouldn't know. Because I still don't want to, like, hurt anyone's feelings or, like, be, you know, people just assume that I'm going to talk about them if they go on a date with me.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm, like, careful about what I post. But, yeah, I'm like, okay, I'm going to at least use this for documenting it, and those TikToks did really well for me. So.
Yeah, I'm so excited that you're, like, going out doing dating updates. I've never, like, been on dating apps, so whenever my friends are, I'm like, I want to know everything. Yeah,
it's kind of, I mean, it kind of sucks. Like, I feel like it's not the best.
Okay. Yeah, every time, like, I talk to my friends, they're like, no, 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 don't get excited.
You're not missing out. I just, like, so I broke up with my boyfriend last year.
Yeah.
It's actually been exactly a year, like, a few days ago.
Oh, wow.
So it's been a year.
Yeah.
And
a year fully single.
Fully single.
It's so exciting.
Yeah. It's exciting. I mean, I'm fully single.
Yeah.
Went on, like, I've been on, I think, like, now with these two Hinge dates, I've been on 4 dates total this past year. But I don't know. I just feel like I'm, like, meant to be single right now. Like, I feel like I'm not in any rush to, like, date. But then I just, like, hear my friends' dating stories as well. And then, like, I'll experience it too. And I'm like, it really is rough out there. Like, it really is. Not even that, like, guys are shitty. Like, there are definitely shitty guys out there. But I think it's more of, like, I feel like it's so hard to, like, find, like, a connection with someone. Like, to actually, like, get along with someone and, like, enjoy talking to them. And, like, I can enjoy, like, talking to you for an hour, but it's, like, do I really want to, like, hang out with you for longer than this?
And I can see that, like, first, if you're doing that, like, first initial interaction so many times, so many different people, and it's never getting farther than that, you're, like,
constantly introducing yourself, and what do you do? Where are you from? Blah, 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 all the small talk.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm like, I just really think dating apps aren't for me. I'm gonna give them a shot, but, like, I just am so much better at, like, an in-person, like, meeting and, like, a natural progression.
You're an extrovert or an introvert?
I'm more of an introvert, but I have to constantly talk to people because of what I do, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, with, like, networking, like, I'm constantly talking to people I don't know for the first time.
You're so good at it.
Thank you. Okay. Yeah, I think I am good at, like, talking to people and networking and all of this, but then it's, like, when I don't have to do that for work, I don't want to do it.
Yeah.
Like, I'd rather just, like, be with people that I'm already comfortable with. So that's why, I hate texting. Like, I am a horrible texter.
I'm what I call painfully extroverted, and I'm a horrible texter.
Yeah, horrible.
Because, like, I'm out talking to other people. Like, I'm like, no, I'm talking to a wall, because I could talk to anybody. If somebody's, like, on my phone, I'm like, I don't.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure I can think of a friend right now that texted me, and that she's actually a coworker, so I've definitely talked to her, like, for work. She texted me on Monday. I definitely haven't answered her.
Oh, yeah, no. I have, like, 20 unopened text messages. I feel so bad. I was supposed to hang out with this one friend of mine on Monday. He texted me Sunday. He was, like, still on for, like, working tomorrow. I just never responded until Monday night. I was like, I am a horrible, like, that's
horrible.
I was like, I am so sorry. I was like, please, like, exclaim the text message or something. Like, I will not get bothered by that. I have so many unopened messages.
Me. Yeah. Just bother me. Annoy me, please. Because I am so, I have a one friend, it's so interesting. So she has ADHD, and I really didn't understand ADHD until I had this friend.
Mm-hmm.
And she talks about her ADHD a lot, and her texting, I can tell when she's, like, going through something or something like that, because she texts me literally, it'll be, like, 10 texts within an hour, and they're all different.
Mm-hmm.
On Tuesday, she was texting me. She was, like, something about a cat, and then it was that she wanted to be able to light on fire without actually burning.
Interesting.
And, like, be able to run around. And then I got a text maybe 6 minutes later. I tried to stick my hair in fire. And then I got a text a minute later saying, confirmed, it does burn quite quickly. I'm like,
oh, my God.
Our friendship works out very well because she can hold herself.
Okay.
Like, she can hold that conversation with herself. And she's never, at least to my mom, she never talked to me about it. She's never pissed when I don't respond till 2 days later.
Mm-hmm.
And I get very overwhelmed by, like, the
big text. I get so overwhelmed by text messages.
I'm like, oh, I'm so scared. So, like, I'll wait until, like, I can't. And then, like, I'll like, choose which ones I'm going to reply to. I'll, like, just ignore some because I realize she just needs stream of consciousness. And then I'll, like, do the reply to be like, oh, cool cat. Stop burning your hair.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Yes. Yeah. No, texting is very overwhelming to me. And especially with dating apps, for example, when I'm like, I'm good once we know each other. Mm-hmm. I can hold, like, banter, whatever. Like, I'll be, like, funny, whatever.
Yeah.
If I don't know you, though, like, I don't know what to say to you. Like, I'm like, what? Okay. Yeah. I'll respond to, like, a prompt or whatever on a dating app. And then usually that's, like, 2 messages. Like, it's not like you can have a whole conversation on, like, one singular prompt. So then it's like, what are you up to? And like, I don't care. Like, I don't care what you're up to. Like, I'm like, I don't know you. So like, but it's so painful for me.
Yeah.
To message people. Yeah. So that's why, like, I'd rather just be like, let's just meet up and see.
Yeah.
But then also it kind of feels like networking in a way, because like, you don't know each other at all. So then you're going through all those questions again. And that's investing
a lot of time. Like, in theory, like, you could be like, if it's good, you could be really skipping like a lot of unnecessary back and forth.
Yes.
And just kind of getting it out of the way. Or like, if it doesn't work out, you're like, okay, well, then I just wasted like time going there, getting rid of like, all the things. Yeah.
So yeah, I'm like, ugh, it's kind of rough, but I'm not in any rush.
Yeah.
I'm just like, for the plot, for the content.
For the plot, for the content. Well, with this era that you're in, I want to make sure we've got some time for, I want to get your opinions on some like controversial dating relationship stuff.
Let's do it.
So, okay, first one, can guys have girl friends, like friends that are girls?
I think they definitely can. Yeah. I just don't think your best friend should be a girl.
Mm.
But I think that they can. I have a lot of guy friends. Yeah. So it would be so hypocritical of me to be like, you can't have girlfriends. Yeah. And in my like previous relationship, he had girlfriends, yeah, like friends that were girls. And I never, you know, there's always, I think girls have very good intuition where if there is something that's like, okay, she likes you, your girlfriend's probably right. Like if it's like, oh, that girl likes you, she's probably right. And she like feels some vibe. But I think for me, like, I can tell instantly if it's like, if someone likes someone or if it's just friends. And like, I think guys,
I do not have that intuition.
No, you do.
No. Mm-mm.
It's a woman's intuition.
I don't know.
I think a woman's intuition is literally like proof. Like, you don't need anything. Like, I'm like, I have been right about like so many things that I've just like had a feeling of.
I have the intuition. I'm really good at not listening. I'm really good at not listening.
No.
Because I will make every excuse for anybody like so many times. I think the absolute best in people, and I don't want to lose that. So like, if I get like a feeling, I think that's like a me problem. I'm like, oh, I'm being whatever, and I will just,
I think that there's a difference aside, though, because like, I can tell if I'm being a little jealous. Like, I can be like,
yeah,
okay, I'm just being jealous, this isn't actually something to be like upset over.
Yeah.
But there's other feelings when you're like, no, I do not like this person. Like, they are, like, not a good person. And I think, like, there's a difference between that. But no, to answer your question, yes, I think guys and girls can be friends.
No, absolutely. But my husband has, like, a lot of friends that are girls. And I would very much consider Joseph, you've never met my husband, Joseph is a girl's girl. Like, he is whore. He is a girl's girl. It is fabulous. He wouldn't let me see Barbie movie without him. Like, he is a girl's girl. I love that.
That's so, it's my funny favorite.
What's your opinion on breaks? Like taking, like people who take breaks.
Okay. Like, what are the rules for a break? You know, like, it's, I just like, is it, if you're on a break, can you hook up with other people? Can you date other people? Can you, that's why I'm like, just break up. And then if you guys want to get back together, get back together.
Yeah, I don't really understand the term break. Like,
I just think it's like, and also whenever people say we're going to go on a break, I'm like, what are you trying to find out? Because when you go through a breakup, that first, like, few weeks, few months is the worst feeling in the world. Like, I think a breakup is, like, the worst pain ever. So, like, if you're just on a break temporarily, you're going to feel that pain. And then instantly you're going to be like, no, I want to stop this pain. Let's just get back together.
Yeah.
I feel like, for the most part. 100%. Or at least one of you is going to feel that way.
I don't understand the whole, like, oh, like, I guess, you know, when people have been dating, if somebody's been dating since, like, high school and they've never had that like personal experience, I could see, like, you know, I don't know, like after college graduating and be like, you know, I want to take some time to explore myself. Like, I've never seen myself as a single person.
Yeah.
Like, I kind of get that. And I mean, me and Joseph started dating freshman year of college. We've known each other since third grade. Like, that would have been something where we, you know, I mean, I guess like we would have, you know, could have been in that situation or whatever. I don't know. I'm just when it's like, oh, like I want to see what it's like to explore with people, make sure I want to stay. I'm like, I'm like, then you don't want
to
stay.
Exactly. Like, to me, just break up. And then like, if you want to get back together later, okay, whatever. You guys can work through things. But like, it's a breakup.
Yeah.
A breakup is a breakup. If you get back together, that's on, like, that's something fine. Else. But like, you're broken up. You can do whatever. I mean, in my eyes, you can do whatever you want.
Yeah. No, you know, it needs to be clean. There needs to be like, otherwise it's just this like random, like, push and pull. You're not getting any closure for anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't. I'm not into it.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. How young is too young to get married? Or thoughts on, like, young marriage?
Okay, so, I mean, I still, it's funny because, like, I'll look on social media and I'll be like, people are getting engaged or married. And
I'm
like,
I saw this girl that got, she was like, I'm married. And then she was like, I'm celebrating my husband's 21st birthday. And I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah. No, but I'll see people like my age, like 27. And I'm like,
I'm just a baby.
I'm like, what? And I'm like, wait, this is like perfectly acceptable to like be married at my age.
I'm such a hypocrite to my core with this. I'll see, again, people my age or older, I'm like, oh my, was there an emergency? Yeah. And I'm like,
oh, she's pregnant. Like,
the kids thing. I'm like, am I saying congratulations or are we in a crisis? Like, yeah. What's going on?
I know.
Like, hey, like, you are married like this. I'm like, who are you talking to? What?
I know. I feel like too young depends. I think a lot of people, how old were you when you got married?
25.
Okay. I think that's a good age. I think that.
Some people on my TikTok were like, that's not young to get married. And I was like, where are you from? Utah?
It is. I think it's like the starting. I would say like 25 ideally would be the youngest.
Yeah. I think 25 is like.
It's a good year. Yeah. You could be older. Younger, it's like, okay, 24 maybe.
Yeah.
But I just think if you graduate college at 22 and then like you're still with the person that you're like, if I think a lot of people, they get engaged literally right after college, especially in the South.
It's very like much in the
you
South.
Graduate and then a I month think later I'm engaged. Also
like, yeah, it's like you, any comments I'm getting, like, look, it's like Utah, Arizona, and then like the Southern states. Yes. And being in the South, and I came from a women's college, it was a huge thing to like, if you get engaged, a lot of people got engaged their senior year and they would literally push that forward because you got thrown in the fountain when you got engaged, if you got engaged while in college. I did some fountain throwing.
Oh my
and
God.
So it was like a thing, and like I think there's definitely like some MRS degrees that were kind of whatever, but that was like in all women's college, it was a thing. And then, or people, they like graduated, get engaged right after, or like get married right after, like within 2 months.
Yeah.
And I'm like,
to me, I'm like, you just, why not wait at least a year after college?
Yeah.
Because you change so much. You guys don't know where you're going to work.
It's, you're getting, like, run through the ringer. Like, you literally, it's...
You're an adult for the first time, I feel like, for a lot of people. Yes.
Yes.
And I'm like, you don't know where you guys are going to work. You're going to change a lot. You're going to... Like, I'm not friends with half the people... Most people I was friends with in college. Yeah. I'm, like, no longer friend. Nothing bad happened. We just, like, drifted apart. Yeah. But I just... And I also think back to, like, my college boyfriend, and I'm like... Oh my God. Like,
yeah. Like, oh my God. Like, that's terrifying.
Yeah. I'm like, I'm very glad I never made that decision. Yeah. You know, because I just like, you change so much after that 1 year after. So I would ideally say enter adulthood. Like, if you never went to college and 18 was your first year of being like an adult, because I think a lot of people go to college and like, they're either still like under their parents.
Yeah. If you're like, still kind of in this like protective bubble, college is a literal. Like, college is a bubble. Like, you're able to live in, like, this world that does not exist outside of that campus. And I love it. Like, there's nothing wrong with that. I think that's fantastic. I think, like, the transition from college to adulthood could have been better. I was bulldozed. But, like, it is, you know, it's not, you don't, you're not experiencing the real world.
That's
the
thing. Like, and if you don't go to college and then you start experiencing the real world at 18, then, okay, maybe 22. I mean, I still think 22 is young, but it's a little different because I think you mature faster.
Yeah.
So it's might be a little different, but I think if you're like the traditional college experience for 4 years and you're just going to get engaged to like your college sweetheart a month later and get married like within 6 months or whatever, like I just think you should live a little more life.
Yeah.
But also like whatever, do whatever you want. But like I personally think 25 is like 25 and up would be ideal.
100%.
So
thank you so much for coming on. I know this won't be the last time.
Every
time we cross paths in New York, we should do this.
Yeah, I really loved this episode. I love how like, casual it is.
It was so, so good. And I need to make more time for Miami. You know that there's a Myrtle Beach flight on Wednesday nights to, like, it's Spirit or, like, Frontier or something. But there and back, whatever, round trip, and it's, like, $25.
Yeah. What?
I've taken it before. It's great.
You can literally come
that's
for lunch.
That's how I did
Zarella event,
yeah,
right?
The Rella event.
Oh,
it was $25.
That is literally cheaper than the Uber to the airport.
Literally.
That is so funny. Yeah. Sometimes you wonder, like, how is it?
No, I am. No, honestly, I don't, because I think anything, like, I'm like, there's so many people on this plane.
Yeah.
I relatively know, like, what plane gas costs, sort of. Like, you guys?
Do you relatively know how much?
In my mind, I do. In my, I am how much an aerospace engineer. Because only because we've been on, like, the little two-seaters or whatever. Mm. And, like, Joseph has friends that are pilots. Okay. And so, like, I know what we paid, like, Jake when we went to lunch in North Carolina. And, okay. Like, so I'm like, yeah. So I understand the cost of a commercial air flight.
Yeah, you understand the logistics.
Like, yeah.
Okay.
A complete expert. Master's degree.
Perfect.
And I think they're scamming us. He's like, do you really understand? I'm like, yeah.
Okay, well, take that flight whenever. I should take that flight.
Yeah. No, you know, and even from Charleston, like, it's you, like, 120.
Perfect. Yeah.
It's so good. Thank you so much for being on.
I loved it. Thanks for having me.
Guys, of course, follow Natalie everywhere. The Real Real, we've got Rella, we've got all the things. Got all the links. We'll put them all in the description as well. Please share this with all your mutual friends. Go to YouTube, go to Spotify, Apple Podcasts, wherever you get your podcast. I hope you have an amazing week, day, wherever you are, and I'll see you guys next time.
Bye.
Bye.